Hi everyone, it's Dr. Sam Robbins. Today's topic is about caffeine, and it's something that I think that's a drug that most people are basically somehow addicted to it. And I bring this up because the number one complaint I hear from people, especially as they've gotten older, is that they're tired all the time, right? They wake up tired, they're dragging at different times throughout the day, they're too tired to exercise or maybe have a good workout, and they're just too tired for a variety of reasons. Ironically, most of these people also don't sleep well, right? They either don't sleep enough or they don't have good quality sleep, and thus they need to actually sleep better, not longer. And these same people are all taking something with caffeine every day. And this can be coffee or tea or energy drinks, cola. I think this includes diet colas, pre-workout, you know, stimulants and supplements and so forth. And caffeine is in so many products and is so common these days and used by almost everyone, including children, you know, because they're drinking soda and teenagers drinking coffee, that nobody gives it a second thought. This is why caffeine is the most used and abused drug on the planet, because people don't even think of it as a drug. But listen, caffeine is so powerful that Coca-Cola's original formula contained cocaine, hence the Coca-Cola part in the name. And the replacement drug for the cocaine was and still is caffeine. By the way, the total milligram dosage of caffeine is usually not listed on most product labels. And many times, in fact, it's underdosed based on variety of studies. And thus, you're actually ingesting even more caffeine than you think. And this is bad because caffeine is linked to anxiety and panic attacks and the thoughts of worry, sleep disturbances and insomnia, which is a big problem, a higher stress hormone such as cortisol, and also lower testosterone levels, nervousness and jitters, increased blood pressure, headaches, osteoporosis, also an increase in blood sugar, fertility issues. This is one I had to do research on. Rapid heartbeat, heartburn, and indigestion, a few other problems. And the truth is that caffeine does make you feel good. Initially, it improves the pleasure chemical dopamine. Unfortunately, continued daily usage decreases dopamine release and dopamine sensitivity. That's a double negative. And I'll be honest with you, I love caffeine, right? I used to use a lot of it to get me through the earlier days when I was going to school and working full time. But I realized it started to cause a lot more harm than good. And yes, caffeine is a drug and it is addictive because it's very hard to just stop it cold turkey, like any drug. Basically, you start to, you know, feel like crap. You can't function well. You can't think clearly. You're very irritable. You know, you have no energy. You have bad headaches. You have lowered sex drive and other withdrawal side effects. And stimulants like caffeine basically burn out your central nervous system and they exhaust your adrenal glands, which leads to hormonal imbalances. So what does this mean for you? Well, if you take products containing caffeine, you should think about lowering the dosages gradually and eventually getting off. You can instead use, you know, natural herbs, nootropics, and coenzymes to increase your energy levels, improve your mood and cognition, and so forth. All good for your body and your brain. And because of this, below in the description area, I have two links that I want you to visit. The first is another YouTube video that I made about this topic, which goes into a little bit more detail. That one's entitled, "The Major Health Problem with Energy Drinks and Caffeine." I also have another link for a natural formula that I use myself to improve my energy levels, my focus, my memory, and just feel happier and just get a lot more work done. So if you use caffeine, you just want better results and healthier body and mind, go ahead and scroll down to the description area, click on one or both the links and improve your health, and then let me know about the positive results you've achieved. Thanks for listening and have a happy and healthy day.